Smiling. Everybody is excited. Around 28 participants are there, but I'm sure there are more than that, way more than that, because in some screens I can see 28 in one screen only. So this is such a brilliant thing to see. Everybody is so excited and enthusiastic. It gives a lot of energy, definitely. Everybody is on their feet. I can see some smiling faces. Brilliant. So guys, this year has been fantastic for RATA, from mere 100 members to now 100 committee members. In the span of 2 years, we have reached around 6,000 MSME sector, MSME companies. And this has been such a wonderful achievement. And this has been a great journey altogether with all you guys, with all the energy, all the enthusiasm people have put in, and so much of effort. Every week, every month, people are showing a lot of enthusiasm. They are coming on time. Everybody is giving their best so that the RATA can move and thrive, and we can actually reach out to a lot of people, to a lot of government organizations. A great, brilliant activity is going on. The association is full pepped up. Even during the time of pandemic, when other associations are dull and low, we are very much high on energy and very much enthusiastic. And I feel that if the energy is right, things will definitely go in right direction. So now coming to the program, it's an amazing, eventful evening today. We'll have a cake cutting ceremony. We'll have address by the national committee members. Then we'll have a Q&A by RATA Gen X committee members. And then we'll also have a thank you note by our past, beloved past president. So handing over to you, Harshal. Now you can start off with the introductions and what is there on the platter.
Who muted me? Rishabh, you have to call Mr. Ajit Panikkar for the speech.
Okay, I got the message. Rishabh is muted, but I got the message, Rishabh. I need to take over. Thanks a
lot. Okay, so... Yeah, I would like to invite our president, our rock star of tonight, who has been putting in a lot of efforts for everything, not just this RATA day, but for all the activities which are going on with RATA. We can all see the enthusiasm and what all is happening by Ajit Panikkar. Everybody knows him and everybody knows that how he follows up with everyone. So maybe that's the reason that everybody knows him now. So here's a great round of applause for our president, Mr. Ajit Panikkar.
Thank you very much, guys. Thanks a lot. So first of all, good evening, everybody. And congratulations to all of y'all, because today, whatever RATA is, everyone has had a role to play. And 72nd year of our foundation. Not many associations or trade bodies or companies even have the privilege to say that they are 72 years old. So it's a legacy that each of us carry. So for putting RATA together, I want to actually congratulate Mihir, the RATA office, Savita, Vishaka, Manohar, and the entire GenX team who has been consistently putting this event together. To most of y'all who do not know what GenX team is, Generation Next is the team that is the generation which is much younger who are part of the industry. Some of them are also the members' children who are still in college who are part of the GenX team. And throughout, we have always made sure from the time we've started RATA Day, we have always made sure that it has to be the youngsters' event. They are the ones always organizing and conducting this event. So it's a fantastic thing that the GenX team is doing. Before I get into I'm not going to get into the vision, the mission, or anything of that sort. I think there are a lot of speakers behind who would actually share that. But I want to share something very important for you to understand. Now, I want you to ask yourself a simple one question, okay? In the last 10 years, pick up your balance sheet, all right? And in that balance sheet, what is the profit you made in that balance sheet? Okay, take an average. Last 10 years I'm talking about. Take an average. And that profit has gone in this financial year? So this financial year in the COVID times, we've all lost that average profit. I'm not talking gross, I'm talking net profit. But seriously, who is the biggest loser in this? Is it you and me? Honestly, it's not. Do you know who is the biggest loser? It is the government of India, because these guys charge 18 and 28%. It is because we did not lose business, we were not able to do business, they lost more money. I don't know if you realized, they are the biggest partners in your profit. And I'm saying not partners in your business, because a partner in a business has an equal share in the profit and in the loss. These guys are the partners in your profit, which is why during the COVID times also, we did not get anything. We were left for us to actually decide. Why does this happen? I want you all to think through this. Why does it happen? An Ambani, Tata, Birla does not need an association or does not take much time to get everyone to stand up and listen. It happens because you and me are small businesses. Nobody has the courage to stand up. I'm worried, right? If I want to stand up, will I get targeted? And why shouldn't I stand up against the government? Because at the end of the day, as entrepreneurs, we have created the business. We run the business. We risk everything. We put our houses on mortgage and we invest in our businesses. We train people and we generate maximum profit, which you get. But we are scared to talk to the government. What kind of a democracy is that? Where we cannot even question what is rightfully ours? Actually, the problem is not with the government. The problem is the way we think, the way we approach the problems. We are too scared to even approach the problem, to approach the government. But when you are 2,000 people, 2,000 companies, you can actually make your voice heard. Farmers' problem which is going on. There are two debates which is there, that it is nice, it is correct, it is not correct. But when they come together, everybody has to stand and listen. My friends, this is very important for us as a very important takeaway. You have to make sure you become a very large organization. Everybody has to become part of this association. Only then we will be able to achieve what we collectively set out to. And why do we have to make the government realize this ecosystem? See, in business, no? You also need a playing field. That playing field should be to your advantage. And how do you create that playing field to your advantage? The biggest influencer is your government. Like how the government is the biggest partner in your business in the profit, he is also the key player. So I am ready to share that profit with the government. But in return, we have to demand what we need to make sure our business grows. And to make that happen, all of us need to come together, not just the current members, but those 3,000 people, 3,000 small businesses need to come together. And when we come together, we can make people stand up and hear us. My friends, when if you don't do that, a market which is growing at the rate of, 8 times over the next 2 decades, 15 years, 20 years down the lane, you will find that this market is only controlled by foreign companies, not just in manufacturing, even in distribution, even in solutions, even in consulting, even in component manufacturing. What will you and me be? Just labor contractors? This is the national wealth which our country is offering us. And as Indians, we have the first right to it. But that right will not come if you don't stand up and ask for it. And the number one problem is our mindset. We are not ready to change. We tend to assume that because we run businesses, we have a know-it-all attitude. In running a business, you might need to know 10 things. But often if you ask yourself what you will need, what you will know is only 2 or 3 things. How do I get to know the balance 7 things? It's very simple. Take those 3 things that you know very well, go out and share it with other people. Unconditionally go out and contribute and share. You will be surprised. The balance 7 things will come from your colleagues. So you have to step out, be part of other people, not only in our industry, but also the other industries. That is how all the other industries have grown. That is how MSMEs across the world has grown. So on this 72nd anniversary, I want each of you all to understand that we are on a mission to help ourselves. In this association, there is only one big gain which we all have, and that gain is measurable. And that is when our businesses grow, both on the top line and the bottom line. That is the only purpose, which is the long-term measurable gain for all of us. And for that, you have to step out, play an active role, and get more and more people to be part of this movement. It's a slow process. It is a painful process. It is a thankless process. But it is the only way we can do it. There's no better way we can do it. We have a 72 years legacy. We have got some of the best people who have become part of 100 really influential people who have become part of the committees. So my biggest message and my biggest request to all of y'all is get moving. There has to be a sense of urgency. We need to get moving and take advantage of what this industry is offering us. So it's a great moment for us. We need to take pride in what we do. We need to celebrate and we need to grow together. Thank you very much and look forward to some great years ahead. Over to you, Harsha.
I would like to introduce Mr. Meet Sanjeev, Vice President National and Mumbai President.
It's always difficult to, you know, follow, I mean, our Narendra Modi of Rata, Mr. Ajit Panekar. Okay, he always starts on a very bright note. And I would just like to say a couple of things, which perhaps I think, you know, Ajit, I think stressed last year, or I think 2 years since we started this Rata Day. Today, we all very proudly celebrate Air Conditioning and Refrigeration Day of India. And we call it as Rata Day. So be proud about what we are, what we do. And that is the best thing what we can do as an association. You know, the best part what I learned in Rata was absolutely selfless giving. That is something what I learned right from my peers. Whether it was Gurnani Saab, whether it was Gosavi Saab, whether it is Paras Bhai, the way they taught us, they created a core. They had Ajit, they had me, they had Deepak Ji, they had Tipu Ji, Ajaspri Ji, they had Akash. We guys came forward. We started forming, and today we have reached out to 13 different committees. When I see 100 people present here, you know, it gives me immense pleasure. You are talking of 13 regions, more than 100 people sitting across and today attending this program. It cannot be anything. But when I stepped into today Rata's office, I mean, there was a very lovely thing what Akash said is that hum log jab ye Rata ki office mein se ek saal pehle nikle the, tabhi hum ek committee thi. आज हम 13 कमिटी है, 13 अलग अलग ऑफिस में बैठे हैं. इससे बेटर हमारे लिए और कुछ नहीं हो सकता. सो दिस इज समथिंग विच इज द बेस्ट थिंग व्हाट हैज हैपेंड फॉर राटा इन लास्ट वन ईयर. एंड वी हैव टू रियली थैंक आर बैकबोन एंड आर बैक ऑफिस. दे हैव डन वंडरफुल जॉब. सो बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर सविता, विशाखा एंड मनहर. दे हैव डन सिंपली आउटस्टैंडिंग जॉब. आई थिंक टुडेज प्रोग्राम वुड नॉट हैव बीन पॉसिबल विदाउट आवर जनरेशन नेक्स्ट. And I have to thank the efforts what Harshal Padia, he led the team today. Rishabh supported him. I mean, imagine we have Harshal sitting in Mumbai, coordinating with Rishabh and Parushan sitting in Delhi, coordinating with Pratik in Bangalore, coordinating with Niranjana in Calcutta, and coordinating with Pranav in Chennai. What better than this? We have next generation leaders already in reckoning, and they are already learning from their peers. What better than that? Our entire trade is in safe hands, and we cannot ask for any more, anything more than this. We have a legacy of 72 years. Someone in 1949 actually thought that we needed an association in the field of air conditioning and refrigeration. Our association had its ups and downs. We got together, got it on the right track. And today when I see so many people sitting and celebrating, it gives me immense pleasure when I see 28 people in Indore celebrating. I mean, it is what better than that? When I see Urvish Bhai and his entire team sitting in Ahmedabad and celebrating. When I see Ambar Ji and all of them sitting in Chennai and celebrating. When I see Amit Ji and team sitting in Delhi and celebrating. आप क्या मांग सकते हो इससे ज्यादा. वी हैव टीम सिटिंग इन बैंगलोर ऑल अक्रॉस इंडिया. Isn't it a true integration of a nation, a true integration of the trade? And when all of us get together, what not we can do? It is said that it takes 7 people to reach out to any context. Imagine, ladies and gentlemen, today we are 100 of us who are sitting here. ये field में ऐसा कौन सा बंदा है जिसको हम लोग पहुंच नहीं सकते या जिसको जिसके साथ में हम contact नहीं बना सकते. So keep this unity. This is how we work together. बोलते हैं संगठन में शक्ति होती है. Let's stay together, stay focused, and achieve. And let's together change the dynamics of the trade. Thank you so much. So, Harshal, I think you are going to talk about the legacy of today's RATA. And when we are talking of three generations, we have our first generation, some representatives, right? So why don't you share something of the first generation? Will you be able to do that?
Videos, right?
Videos, absolutely.
So before that, we have to introduce.
Sure. So why don't you start with that? Introduction.
Good evening, everyone. Happy RATA Day to everyone. I would like to introduce our office bearers of National RATA National Office Bearers, Mr. President National, Past President Mumbai, Ajit Panikar, National President and Past President Mumbai. Mr. Mihir Sanghvi, Vice President National and Mumbai President. Mr. C. Subramaniam, Bangalore Secretary National and Bangalore President. Is it clear? Mr. Urvesh Shah, Joint Secretary National and Ahmedabad President. Mr. Akash Verma, Treasurer National and Treasurer Mumbai Chapter. Paryush M. Gadiali, Assistant Treasurer National and Surat President. Mr. Paras Siroya, Membership National and Past President, Mumbai. We have 5 videos of our industry stalwarts. I would name that Mr. Ulas Chororia, Mr. Anand Gosavi sir, Radhisham Gurnani sir, Jagdish Parikh sir, Valisji and Jagdish Verma, sir. So I would like to play that videos and I would like to hear that what they have to say about RATA, as it is very important for all our committees across India, as what they have done for RATA and what they see as RATA in future. Savita, would you play the videos? And we have Q&As in between that videos to all our RNC office bearers.
There's no audio.
Where are you?
மெசேஜ் அமிச்சுட்டுமா நீங்க அனுப்புறீங்க
जो कि इसके फाउंडर मेंबर थे, उन्होंने अपने पाकिस्तान को खोला था और उसके बाद में इसकी जर्नी अथक जर्नी स्टार्ट की, जिसमें सारी सारी
Now played.
My channel is doing it.
जर्नी बहुत लंबी है. यह संस्था भारत की स्वतंत्रता के पहले ही बनी थी. 1945 के बीच में इसका था. इस संस्था के मुख्य संस्था फजल बाई जो कि इसके फाउंडर मेंबर थे, उन्होंने अपने उसके बाद और वर्मा जी तीनों सक्रिय मेंबर थे. हम लोग सभी हर एक प्रत्येक मंथली मीटिंग के अंदर वोल्टेज हाउस में जाकर के ज्वाइन करते थे. 3 से 6 बजे तक का टाइम होता था. इस बीच में हम लोग सारे विषयों पे बातचीत करते थे, जो समस्याएं हैं उनको सुलझाते थे. इसके अलावा कुछ इंटरटेनमेंट भी लास्ट में करते थे. वहाँ पर अच्छी तरह से मीटिंगें चलती थी. इसके मीटिंग को चलाने में अहम रोल हमारे SC घोष साहब थे, बाबू घोष बाबू, उन्होंने निभाया था. वो करीब 30-35 वर्षों तक इसके चेयरमैन बने रहे और उनका लगाव इतना था संस्था के प्रति कि सारे रिपोर्ट वगैरह सब मेंटेन करने में उनकी अहम भूमिका थी. इसके बाद भी जैसे जैसे टाटा के काम का विस्तार हुआ तो हमारे सामने एक समस्या आई कि भी इसका अपना ऑफिस होना चाहिए. तो इस समस्या को निपटाने के लिए हमें तुरंत 60 दिनों में ऑफिस लेने की प्रक्रिया शुरू कर दी और जो अमाउंट 20 लाख के करीब इसमें ऑफिस लेने में लगा था वह 60 दिन के अंदर अंदर इकट्ठा हो गया और सभी ने अति उत्साह के साथ में अपना योगदान दिया. और इसके बाद में AC मार्केट ताड़देव के अंदर इस ऑफिस का चयन हुआ और वहां से इसका अधिग्रहण हुआ. इसकी ऑफिस लेने की प्रक्रिया भी बड़ी धूमधाम से मनाई गई और बड़े मंत्रोच्चार के साथ में ऑफिस का भव्य उद्घाटन हुआ. इसके बाद में इसकी जर्नी चलती गई और सारे मेंबर्स सक्रिय रूप से भाग लेने लगे और मैं भी बहुत सक्रिय था. इसी बीच मैं सन 1971 से लेके 2005 तक मैं इसका सक्रिय मेंबर रहा हूँ. हर मीटिंग हर प्रोग्राम को मैंने मेरी सहभागिता रही हुई है. प्रोग्राम कहीं बाहर भी हुए हैं और बॉम्बे में तो होते ही रहते थे, उसमें मेरी 100% सहभागिता रहती थी. इसके बाद में ये जर्नी चलती रही और मैं इसका 2005 तक साक्षी हूँ कि मैंने सक्रियता के साथ राटा का काम में सहयोग दिया है. और मैं यही चाहता हूँ कि ट्रेडर्स कम्युनिटी इस काम में पूरा सहयोग दे, क्योंकि हमारे जो मैन्युफैक्चर समुदाय के जो भी लोग हैं, बड़े बड़ी कंपनियां, वो हमें उत्साहित करती थी ट्रेडरों को उत्साहित करती थी कि भाई आप लोग भी एक दिन मैन्युफैक्चरर बन सकते हो, इस स्टेप में आप आगे बढ़ते जाओ। और उनसे कोई भी हमारी समस्या होती थी मैन्युफैक्चरिंग के मामले में तो हम उनसे सलाह लेते थे और वो हमें निःशुल्क बड़े प्रेम से हमारे आगे बढ़ने की जर्नी को प्रोत्साहित करने के लिए हरदम वो उत्सुक रहते थे। इसलिए मैं तमाम मैन्युफैक्चरर लोगों का, मैन्युफैक्चरर कम्युनिटी का, मैं तमाम मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कम्युनिटी को अपने तहे दिल से शुक्रगुजार हूँ कि उन्होंने ट्रेडर्स कम्युनिटी को बहुत आगे बढ़ाया है। इसलिए हमें ये हरदम ध्यान रखना है कि मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कम्युनिटी को साथ में लेकर के ही ट्रेडर्स काम करें। यदि कोई भी मैन्युफैक्चरर्स जो है वो थोड़ा टाइम कम समय देता है तो भी कोई बात नहीं है, पर उसका सहयोग हरदम देते रहें, उससे सलाह लेते रहें तो ही हम आगे बढ़ सकते हैं। आज के परिवेश में जब हम 2020 में प्रवेश किया है तो हमने एक बड़ी समस्या का इसको देखा है, वर्ल्ड वाइड जो समस्या आई है कोरोना की उसको हमने प्रत्यक्ष देखा है। और इसी संदर्भ में जब अमेरिका की फाइजर कंपनी ने पहला टीका बनाया है तो वो -80 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड में रखा जाएगा, इसलिए बड़ी संख्या में, लाखों की संख्या में डीप फ्रीजरों की ज़रूरत होगी और पूरे विश्व में ये डीप फ्रीजर की डिमांड है। और मैं अपना छोटी मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कंपनियों को ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि वो अपना पूरा ताकत जोर लगाएं और ये डीप फ्रीजर जहाँ जहाँ भी डिमांड है उसको क्रिएट करके उनको सहयोग दे करके और सप्लाई करें, ताकि हमारे मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कम्युनिटी का भी फायदा हो, ट्रेडर्स कम्युनिटी का भी फायदा हो और पूर्ण देश हमारे पे आशा लगा के बैठा है कि कोल्ड चेन से कब ये अति उपलब्ध जितनी संख्या में चाहिए वो मिल पाएगी। इसीलिए हमारे पूरे देश की, नरेंद्र मोदी जी की भी इसमें बड़ी चाहना है कि कोल्ड चेन आगे बढ़े। और इन सब में मैं एक नाम अभी भी लेना भूल गया हूँ, मुझे क्षमा करें, HL शर्मा जी जो कि उस वक्त में डेनफोर्स में थे, वो भी प्रत्येक मीटिंग के अंदर हम लोगों के साथ थे, हमारी उम्र के वो थे और उन्होंने हमें आगे बढ़ाने में बहुत, तो HL शर्मा जी का भी मैं है उन्हें पुनः धन्यवाद करता हूँ और चाहता हूँ कि उनकी दीर्घ यात्रा, उनका जीवन सफल हो और वे आगे से आगे पर प्रोस्परस करते रहें। धन्यवाद।
No, Mir, actually, can we just introduce the person? Of course, in Bombay, all of us know who Mr. Chaudhary is, but if for the rest of the country, if somebody can introduce him, then it makes it much more better. So everybody knows who he is. Yeah, over to you, Akash.
Can you hear me, Ajit?
Yes, Akash, go ahead. Please go ahead.
Yeah, so we just had the video of Ulas G. Chaudhary. He is from Bolton Trading Corporation, father of Pankaj Chaudhary. So he was an active part of RATA's beginning journey. And along with him, there have been another 5 ex-presidents of RATA whose videos we have with us today. So the next person we have is Anand Gosavi Ji. Anand Gosavi Ji is residing in Kolhapur now. He has been extremely active with RATA in terms of getting all the ROC work done for RATA as a limited company with the government. It was something which was impossible. We didn't have any idea of how it is done. He was the one who also has been at many times the for the elections. He has been the returning officer and he has ensured that there's fairness in everything that RATA is doing during the election. So let us welcome and listen to the views of Anand Gosavi Ji now.
When I took RATA's charge as a secretary, That time my first task was to clear the income tax matter and our ROC matters. RATA has not filed that time, returns were not filed for last 6 to 7 years. So the existing that time the charter accountant was in Mahim, but he was not cooperating with us. He said there is no need of filing returns for RATA. But I was confirmed, no, I want to clear everything, we want to recognize everything, and we want to file returns of all pending years. But he never cooperated with us. So we decided to move to our old charter accountant. He was in Machit Bandar. I forgot his name, Shamji, I think. And Mr. Vandas also agreed, and Varamaji also agreed. Everybody, committee member agreed, okay, we should shift to there. Then myself by Kirit Bhai, that time was a treasurer. So myself by Kirit Bhai went, his office was in Machit Bandar. We met him, but he was not ready. He had some problems. So somehow we convinced and he agreed to solve our problem. And initially as per his whatever requirement he made it, we fulfilled it and everything was regularized. All returns were filed in order. Then ROC returns were also filed in order. That was a major achievement we had done during my period. Second blow RATA got was financially that 64 units were collapsed. And we used to get very good amount of dividend and that we used to manage our day-to-day affairs with the dividend only. But then they stopped paying us nothing. The dividend, they stopped paying us, and that was a great time because our main income was unit 64 dividend. Then we decided to control our expenses. Of course, then we had new office. That time we were taking at Prabhadevi. Then on Chabil, of course, we have got limited staff, only Chabildas was there, and whatever work he used to do, myself and Wallace, he guided me very well in doing the office work. We used to do all our manually, everything was done by us. We never hired any outside person to do the Java Prada because there was no finance available, the critical condition. And whatever we used to get a membership, we used to convert them into FDs. So, but we never broke any FD to run the day-to-day affairs of Prada. Then that too also we followed the matter. Then my office was at New Bombay and it took our almost 1.5 years to recover the money. Of course, we got hardly 75,000 rupees. Our investment was more than 6 to 7 lakhs in unit funds. But we could recover hardly that to follow up 1.5 years. I think these are the major achievements RATA got. We recognized the things which were mess. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Gurnani. Thank you, Anand Goswami ji. And now we have another very, very important person who has been there in the history of RATA. It's Radhesham Gurnani ji. He has a little bit of relationship with our current president, Ajit Panikkar. So I know the surnames don't match, but that is because Ajit is the son-in-law of Radhesham Gurnani ji. And Ajit, the poor guy, was working in a nice corporate cushy life. This is the way he has entered our industry. And today, he's trying to bring together this entire trade. Hats off to you, Ajit. And our respect to Radhesham Gurnani ji. Let us listen to his views of what he thinks about you being capable enough in RATA.
Hello, RATA members. My name is Radhakrishnan Gurnani, and I have been member of Room Agriculture Trade Association since 1980. It was a humble beginning with about 40 members at that time. Our relationship was personal and strong to carry it forward to grow it to the present position. We used to have a monthly meeting at Volta Sagar, Ballard State at that time. At that time, we were the only region who purchased own office at Prabhadevi for organizing Bollywood musical show with the help of past President Tejinder Singh and other committee members. This was a great achievement. The decision went a long way to ensure that the organization was financially stable and had base to grow steadily. During this time, permit raj was prevailing. Nothing could move without the permission of central government. At that time, Simbalski industry was allowed to manufacture goods worth 5 lakhs with exemption of excise duty. Approximate price of Voltas 1 ton was about 4,000. Corporate sector like Voltas, Blue Star, Feders, others who also RATA members then got separated and formed their own association called RAMA at New Delhi. By this act, RATA was having members represented by traders and service providers who mainly had practical knowledge, but all the personal bonding with all the members and entrepreneurs was strong, and we survived these times when there were no professionals like engineers, CA, MBA, like today's times. I wish all the best to young generation of RATA members team who are carrying on activities in an extremely professional way with about 30 offices around all over India and taking RATA to a great level. Thank you and all the best to RATA again.
I hope everyone has been able to follow Gurnani ji's speech, because there was a little issue with the video. Ajit, was that clear?
The audio was clear. The video was playing a little bad, but it's okay. The audio was pretty clear.
Yeah. What I would like to say about Gurnani ji is that he is one of the most positive people around, and he has ensured that even at times when, you know, we were trying to recover, he said, don't worry, just stay together and it will happen. We didn't know that he had a big ace up his sleeve through Ajit, who was going to come and turn this around, and they had a big plan. But thank you. Ajit, please give our regards to Gurnani ji.
Akash, you know I didn't have a choice, right?
Wo daru pe baat karenge. And now we have the next very, very important... Ajit, there is a request from some of the committee members from various regions if we can do the cake cutting now,
yes,
and then continue with the rest so that,
yes,
some of them
that.
Who have to leave can...
Yes, yes, please do that. Please do that, because they would like to cut the cake and then we can stay all connected again.
Okay, I will give it to...
cake.
Let's request all the regions to bring the cake in the center of their tables and let us have a joint cake cutting. I think some regions have already cut their cakes. Ajit, please ensure that they are given higher targets this year.
We have lady in the house here. Come on.
I think what you should do is, I think, why don't we get Savita, Vishaka and Manoj. You cut that. You guys cut that. Come.
Yeah, yeah, please. Come. That's how it should be. That's how it is. That's
right. Absolutely.
So you guys just need to unmute yourself, Akash, on that screen. Just unmute.
Anybody playing the birthday song?
Can you unmute yourself, Akash? We can't hear you there. Can you just unmute? Oh, this is nice. Ahmedabad, you got a lovely cake.
Yeah, fantastic.
Ahmedabad, fantastic cake, Ahmedabad. It's fabulous.
Dilip bhai, jara cake nazdik mein lao, dikhe to sahi.
Vadodara,
fantastic. Ah, ye hui na baat.
Superb. Awesome, man.
All
right, thank you very much. Okay, go ahead, guys. Cut the cake. Bombay's cut it. Everybody else also, please cut the cake. Awesome. Fantastic, Vadodara.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, Ahmedabad. That is so cool. Amazing. So Indore and Chennai has also done it. They did send us the photographs on the group.
Baroda bhi kaat rahi hai na.
Congratulations, Pune. Congratulations, Dilip bhai. Fantastic. Fabulous. I don't know if you have all realized, I just did a quick count of how many people are actually there. We are about close to about 100 odd people, right? There's 40 logins, but we're about close to 100 odd people. A rough count that I did in the last 20 minutes, it's about close to 100 odd people. Congratulations, guys. Fantastic. Fabulous. Thank you for all this initiative and taking time out and doing this. This is fabulous. Sometimes, you know, these small things go a long way in remembering. We might not remember I'm sorry, Amod.
I said, I'm sorry, I missed out being in the RATA office today.
Ha, cool. Yeah, but it's
congratulations.
Because, yeah, so sometimes you tend to forget about the things that you gone ahead and achieved, but you know, these small things that we do together remains very memorable. So, fabulous. Thank you to you, Harsha.
Yes.
Hello, everyone, to congratulate and happy birthday.
Thank you, Manojji. Fabulous to see you out here. And fantastic.
That was a fantastic. Sorry, Ajit.
Amari khub khub.
Sorry, you were saying.
Shubh kamna hai.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Mehroji is saying something. Why don't you? Mehroji, would you like to say something?
Yeah.
We have one of our senior members.
Congratulate from Surat, Mr. Ajit, Mr. Mir, Mr. Akash, and where is Paras? Today, Mr. Paras
is also here.
He's also there. He joined us from Chennai.
Okay. No, fine. Everyone, congratulate.
Okay.
Thanks.
Congratulations to everyone. Happy birthday.
So Manoji, I have want to share something with you. You know, people like Mihir, Akash and me and all, we did not have a choice but to, we were pushed into RATA and we had no coming back from it. There is only one way to go. So we were given a one-way ticket and we were told, abhi jaake RATA ko khada karo. So you you have to do the same thing. You have to give that one-way ticket to Paurush and tell him that abhi jaake khada karo.
Okay. Congratulate.
Thank you very much.
Manoj bhai, same Guru Nani sahab ne Ajit ke father ne father in law ne yehi kiya tha, usko one way ticket diya.
Yeah, over to you, Akash, go ahead.
In fact, I think because he knew that Ajit was joining the refrigeration industry. This is the time when Ajit had to give dowry to his wife when he actually came in. So, payback time, Ajit, payback time. And now, with permission of the August gathering, we will go to our next speaker, Mr. Jagdish Ji Parekh. He has been an extremely important part in, there was a big program that was done over here. It was a fundraising program at that time when RATA didn't have enough funds, and thereafter we have been also able to start with this own office that we have at Prabhadevi in the center of Mumbai. So let us listen to Jagdish Ji Parekh.
Good morning, my RATA friends. I'm very thankful to Parasya Verma Ji who has given me opportunity to say few words for RATA. मुझे बताया गया कि आपके टाइम पे आपने राटा के लिए क्या योगदान दिया, उनके लिए दो दो शब्द बोलना है। दो शब्द मेरी स्पीच शुरू करूं उसके
अजीत, कैन यू शेयर द वीडियो प्लीज?
ओके, होल्ड ऑन, जस्ट म्यूट योरसेल्फ आउट देयर, लेट मी सी इफ आई कैन शेयर इट, होल्ड ऑन। Unfortunately, I'm not able to share, guys. You guys will have to do it. Sorry guys, you will have to play it. I won't be able to play it. There is an issue here. So you guys will have to play it. I'm sorry.
Good morning, my RATA friends. I'm very thankful to Parasya Verma Ji who has given me opportunity to say few words for RATA. मुझे बताया गया कि आपके टाइम पे आपने राटा के लिए क्या योगदान दिया, उनके लिए दो दो शब्द बोलना है। दो शब्द मेरी स्पीच शुरू करूं उसके पहले राटा के लिए काफ़ी सेक्रीफाइस किया, उनका नाम मैं देना चाहता हूं। जसबीर साहब, वर्मा साहब, उल्लास जी, वैली साहब, माय डियर फ्रेंड तेजेंद्र जी, गोप साहब, दीपक दालबिया, हितू भाई, किरीट भाई एंड पारस, सभी लोग मिलकर काफ़ी लोग अच्छा काम कर रहे थे। राटा के पास में ऑफिस नहीं थी तो बाबलेश्वर में हम लोग गए थे, तो वहाँ पे डिस्कस किया गया कि राटा की ऑफिस के लिए क्या किया जाए। आई हैव सजेस्टेड टू कि भाई एक फंड रेजिंग प्रोग्राम करते हैं। फिर 99 में हम लोग ने एक फंड रेजिंग प्रोग्राम किया विलेपाला वेस्ट में भाईदास जो में संजीवनी बेलांडे का नाम से, और काफ़ी अच्छा प्रोग्राम गया, काफ़ी सक्सेस गया। उन पैसे से ऑफिस किया गया, ऑफिस परचेस किया गया। इन दिनों में पारा से उसकी टीम अच्छा काम कर रही है, मैं उनको शुभेच्छा देना चाहता हूँ और मेरा दो शब्द पूरा कर रहा हूँ। जय हिंद।
मूविंग ऑन इन द जर्नी वी हैव मिस्टर वैलेस। Mr. Wallace is the proprietor of Modern Air Conditioning Services. He has an office in Mumbai and in Goa. Right now, he is enjoying his life in his house in Goa. And from there, he has sent us a video in his own way of humor that he always lived in RATA. Again, a person who was the secretary at RATA for a long time and his important contribution to RATA in the past.
Hello members of RATA and all the people from our trade. Today I am going to give a small description or information about RATA as far as what I know. You all know that RATA was started in 1949. Under the presidency of Mr. Ahmad A. Fazal Boy. At that time, lot of prominent people were members of this glorious association. All corporates were handling this association. After 1985, we realized that certain section of our trade was not well represented in this association. Therefore, prominent persons in our trade, just like Mr. Ullas ji, late Jasbir Singh, late Mr. Ram Prasad Ruiya, Mr. Tejinder Singh, they all got together and took control of this association from the corporates and established an office. They bought an office in Tardeo, a prominent place, a small office, and employed one manager and one manager, Mr. Matthew, and one Mr. Shabil Das. They were very useful for us until very long time. Thereafter, it was time to celebrate our golden jubilee, and we started making preparations right from 1997. The golden jubilee was celebrated in 1999. It was a very tough thing to organize this occasion, but all the members of the association came forward and gave their help. It was started by sending circulars to all the members to give a suitable contribution to organize this function. Unfortunately, no one contributed. Only one, Mr. Iqbal Bhai Bagaswala, he contributed 2,000 rupees by check. It was a very handsome contribution during that time. But we realized that we could not do something by sitting in the office. We have to move out. Mr. Tejinder Singh was the president at that time. He told me, "Mr. Wallace, you please take lead and I give you all the powers to organize this function." So I gathered some very prominent people to handle this task. I formed a celebration committee consisting of many important persons who became very prominent thereafter, like Mr. Anand Gosavi, Mr. Paras, Mr. Kirit Bhai, Mr. Jagdish Parikh, and many more. And there were certain very more important people like Mr. Dinesh Prabhu. During that time, unfortunately, we had sold our office at Tardeo and we were left with no place to sit to organize ourselves. At that time, Mr. Dinesh Prabhu shouldered the responsibility. He said, "Don't worry, I have taken a new place in Santa Cruz. I am leaving it to your disposal to get together, work from there, organize yourself and go ahead with the function." He helped us a lot. He used to, whenever we used to have a meeting, we used to have a meeting there every Saturday, and all the members who are in the committee for celebration used to come there. He used to, apart from giving his office, he used to entertain us also. At that time, we realized that by sitting in the office, we cannot get contribution. I made decision and requested our senior people like Mr. late Tejinder Singh, Mr. Dinesh Prabhu, Mr. Jagdish Parikh, and all to go and visit the people at their business premises. It was a great success. Wherever they went, they received tremendous entertainment, because senior people like Mr. Jasbir Singh, Mr. Tejinder Singh went there from shop to shop. Mr. J.C. Verma. Mr. J.C. Verma was very instrumental in guiding us, and he himself joined the people, all these members, to go and get good contribution. Fortunately, we got very good contribution and we made a very glorious celebration. And we collected a lot of money. Lot of corporates also helped us, like Tekumsha, Kirloskar and all prominent people at that time, they helped us. And after that, receiving that money, we thought that we should buy an office. We tried many places, but it was out of our budget. At that time, one Mr. Nirmal, he spotted one place at the present office where we are in Prabhadevi. He made arrangement and we got that place at a very good price and we did not even have to pay any brokerage. It was a big contribution and it was a big advantage that we had. Rata Bombay was having its own office. It was indeed a very good success. And if you go through the souvenir, you will see a lot of information. And I once again thank all, especially Mr. Dinesh Prabhu, Mr. Verma ji, Ms. late Tejinder Singh, and all these people. I cannot recollect anything more. But anyway, whatever we organized that time, it gave a good inspiration to people to come and work for the association. Mr. Paras became the president, Mr. Anand Gosavi became the president, and all the supporting members gave a lot of assistance. This is what I can share, and I hope this information will be very handy to many of our members. Thank you.
So that was Valisji, as I just informed all of you that he was the secretary at RATA. In fact, he also sent me one more video when he was recording this video. He said, I have to tell all of the members what had happened in the past. It was a small story. So he said, how did I become secretary? So he was, at that time at his home when Verma ji and late Jasbir ji, they both went to his house and they told him, just come out, we have to take you somewhere. And he said, Nani, what is it for? But they finally convinced him. They took him to one restaurant, made him sit over there, and he said, Terko secretary banne ka hai. And this is what I mean. He was saying, no, usko khana khilaya, daru khilaya, jo bhi karwaya. But by the time he left that restaurant, he agreed to become secretary and serve at RATA. So by hook or by crook, we must ensure that if we have a vision, we will make people join and we will ensure that we reach where we want it. And now the next speaker, Mihir would like to introduce.
So friends, I think next person whom I would like to introduce is a very special person, Mr. J.C. Verma. Verma Saab's, one of the biggest contribution was to get Danfoss into India. And the second contribution is the person sitting right next to me. Okay, Akash Verma. He gave Akash Verma to RATA. Okay. I mean, James Bond of Mr. Subbu. Is Subbu around? I don't know whether I can see him.
I'm here.
Yeah, Subbu. So your James Bond was given to us by Mr. J.C. Verma.
Yeah. He's our James Bond.
Yes. So senior Bond is there. We have to go and thank him in Anand. Okay, so on a serious note, Mr. Verma has given a very, very special emotional note, and he wants to talk on behalf of late Jasbir ji, late Tejinder Singh ji, and he wants to talk about their contribution, how they went about RATA, and that's what it is all about. So let's hear Mr. J.C. Verma. We really apologize for the poor video quality. But we will be sharing these videos with all of you, please.
Refrigeration and Air Conditioning Trade Association
in short, called Rata Western Region, was founded in 1948-49, almost 72 years ago, having a head office in Mumbai. It was started by legend people like Ahmed Fazal Boy, engaged in trading line of Tecumseh compressors and all types of gases, etc. Advani Group of Blue Star, Voltas, Bottle Boy, Trick India, Kirloskar, Vulcan Level, and other large and small scale industries and leading traders community. Voltas was distributed for Amol products. Similarly, all above companies were partly. Rata is always electing president unanimously. This includes past elected president Mr. Janjani, Gidwani, Mr. Shishu, Mr. Banerjee. I was also the president of Rata from 1993 to 96. I was also chairman of IMPO, where we used to represent to finance ministry regarding high rate of duty, as much as 60% of custom duty, plus 131.5% excise in terms of CVD. During that time, there used to be licensing system, and I played my role to guide the industry for pros and cons of import. Our industry, because of Indo AC, were used to be treated as luxurious industries anyway with our representations, and as per WTO, we had a sigh of relief. In 70s onwards, we used to attend all monthly RATA meetings in Volta's house. Myself, Mr. Jasveer Ulas, Mr. Ruya, Mr. H.L. Sharma were attending regularly. Interestingly, Mr. H.K. Ghosh was the secretary of RATA for indefinite time, as he was almost retired and kept interest in RATA. From Voltas, Mr. Ramchandra also used to attend the meetings. In 70s onwards, we used to attend all monthly RATA meetings in Voltas' house. Myself, Mr. Jasveer Ulas, Mr. Ruya, Mr. H.L. Sharma were attending regularly. Interestingly, Mr. H.K. Ghosh was the secretary of RATA for indefinite time, as he was almost retired and kept interest in RATA. From Voltas, Mr. Ramchandra also used to attend the meetings. Since time allotted is short, I would not forget to mention about the younger generation who is contributing to the top level for the progress of RATA Bombay. In Tardev and later a bigger office in Prabhadevi side. Your younger generation has really impressed me with their views and devoting the best time to bring up the RATA functions. I have attended a few times your functions and really appreciate your heartfelt contribution to the elders by giving the awards and respect which we cannot forget. Our Prime Minister has come out with a new slogan, that is Vocal for Local. This has to be adopted by all 1.35 billion population in India. I am sure RATA is already moving in this line. I have seen number of your RATA members who have really gone into erection jobs and also acquiring lot of knowledge for the progress of the trade and industry. I wish all the best and my blessings to the younger people.
Thank you.
we come to the end of listening to the wonderful views that all our ex-presidents in RATA have had about what they feel about RATA today and their experience while they were active with RATA. I would like to share one thing. When we were getting these videos from all these ex-presidents that we, you know, tried to contact, you will not believe the enthusiasm they had to come and share. What they feel about all our efforts that we are putting in for our trade. In fact, you know, I had asked them that, can you do this recording in 3 days and send it? They all managed to send it in 3 days, but they also ensured to send me a message by the night after they had sent the message saying, listen, I don't like what I have recorded. I would like to record it once again, and please give me some more time. So this is what they meant by perfection, whether it is what they did in the past or whatever contribution we ask of them today. So we should say hats off to their spirit and to what we all have been continuing as second generation and many as first generation who are part of the trade today. Thank you. I will now hand it over to Hardik. Hardik is taking up the question answer session. Hardik, Dhrumil and Amitesh
and
Prateek from Bangalore, our Gen Next heroes, are now going to ask some very, very interesting questions to some of the committee members at the National RATA Committee. Over to you guys.
It's random for you.
Oh, so the Gen Next is going to ask questions to the National Committee members. If any of you National Committee so any of the National Committee members, if any of the National RNC members don't like the question, feel free to ask the question back again. You can ask the question to another question to the Gen Next. Okay, it's high time they also started taking the lead.
The first question is from Parashar. How does RATA help in government life?
I can see Parashar. Parashar are there.
Parashar ji, aap hai. Ajit, can you see Parashar ji?
Yes, yes,
yes, he's there. Yes, I am.
Please.
Kahan jaunga RATA ko jod ke.
Parashar ji, ek question aapke liye hai.
Alai bab phodne wale hai kya mere upar?
Parash sir, this question is for you, that how does RATA help with government licensing? What support can RATA give?
Vapas bol.
Parash bhai, lifeline chahiye.
Awaaz mein kuch disturb.
Phone a friend. All 20 lakhs or less than 20 lakhs.
Thank you, RATA. Government licensing mein paise aaj contribute kar rahi hai.
सवाल वापस पढ़ेंगे मेरे को नहीं सुनाई दिया
पारस जी राटा गवर्नमेंट लाइजनिंग में आज कैसे हेल्प कर रही है
हम गवर्नमेंट की और किस तरह से पहुंच रहे हैं किस तरह से उनको अप्रोच कर रहे हैं
ये जवाब तो मेरे ख्याल से गवर्नमेंट लाइजनिंग वाले ही देने चाहिए कि कैसे परफॉर्म कर रही है
पारस जी जेन नेक्स्ट ने ऐसे ही किया है कि जिसमें आप आज नहीं हो वही क्वेश्चन दूसरे को पूछ रहे हैं अभी आपको पता लगे कि दूसरा कर क्या रहा है
चलो ठीक है ये तो काम तो बहुत अच्छा हो रहा है गवर्नमेंट लाइजनिंग में अभी खाली हमारे को प्राइम मिनिस्टर तक पहुंचने की देरी है बाकी सब जगह पहुंच चुके हैं
That was on a lighter note. Ajit, would you like to say, I think, how we have reached out to government and I think what are all
so,
the
yeah. So government reach out is very important. You must realize that without a government reach out, most people who are in business will always realize that, you know, the government has a very big role to play in your business. And you have to engage with them directly and you have to, and it's not easy. So our strategy is very simple. We have to go from the state and also from the center. And how do you actually go about it is you have to, there are two mechanisms. One mechanism is you have a team which is actually reaching directly to the government. This is what you call as a cold call. You are going there and you're actually knocking doors and saying, sir, humse milo, humse milo, humse milo, humse milo. The second thing is through a referral. Kisi ka referral rekhe hum jaate. That is typical sales calls, right? How we do? Cold call and referral calls. So cold call is actually going directly. That is the government reach out team. Referral is the trade reach out team, which is what we call as a business reach out team. What they do is they actually go and take membership of other associations. Like you have the Indian Merchant Chambers, Gujarat Chamber of Commerce, Ashokem, Ahmedabad Chamber of Commerce, Vadodara Chamber of Commerce, Maratha Chamber of Commerce. So we take membership there. And through them, we reach the government, right? Because usually, so how we got to meet Nitin Gadkari ji was through a referral. Indian Merchant Chambers actually sent us, gave us a recommendation and told that this is a very interesting organization. You must meet them. And because the referral was there, the Nitin Gadkari ji's office reached out and started talking to us. So is the case with Mr. Piyush Goyal, and so is the case with so many other state associations. So that is the whole reach out. And you have to reach out to the GST Council, which is very important. So the GST commissioners play a very, very important role. So they are key influencers. They are actually executors. They're not policymakers, but they will play a very key important role in influencing a change. So you have to reach out to them. You have to reach out to the MSME ministry. So the MSME ministry is a ministry which has comes under Nitin Gadkari ji. It's a central subject and they have a great role in most of the MSME schemes we are not even aware of. We are not even taking advantage of. So first is being knowledge and taking advantage of it. So having done this, we have to reach the center. So the center and state, in a typical federal system like ours, you need to bring the center and the state together. Now you don't have to bring all the states. It is all about majority of the big states getting active. So the big business states, if they get active, then it is quite easy to influence the government. It's a one-time, very difficult effort, but once you build a relationship, it is fantastic. Then they are always reaching out to you. And this government is very proactive. They like to reach out to business communities, but we are late in the game. There are other business communities are ahead of us. So we'll have to put in little extra effort and reach out to them. And that's the only way. And this is the larger game plan that we have, that we need to make the government see. The government has already made you part of the business. They are taking the majority share out of your business. It is for you to now make sure that this big partner, the senior partner, is also helping you out in your business. And for that, you have to reach out. That's the whole thing. Over to you, Akash. Yeah.
Thanks, Ajit. So Paras bhai, since you passed on the first question, second question is
itna lamba jawab
dene ke baad fifth question ho gaya.
So the question is, did Rata personally help you in your business? If so, how?
Mere liye
hai. Ha Paras bhai, aapke liye, go ahead.
Dekho, aisi baat hai,
ugly question.
Personal business mein Rata jitna help karti hai, mere ko nahi lagta aapko अपना बिजनेस में उतना हेल्प करता होगा. आप खुद अपने आप को इतना हेल्प नहीं कर पाओगे जितना आपको राटा कर पाएगी या राटा करती है. ये आपको मालूम नहीं पड़ता है, बट जब आप यहाँ आते हो तो आपको मालूम पड़ेगा. जो लोग यहाँ पे हैं उनको पूछो, उनके बिजनेस ऐसा लगता है ना कि किसी को लगता है कि मेरा बिजनेस पूरा हैम्पर हो रहा है और मैं बिजनेस कुछ कर ही नहीं पा रहा हूँ, बट उसको पीछे से जब मालूम पड़ता है कि अरे बिजनेस तो बहुत अच्छा हो रहा है और बिजनेस में तो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स ही काम करते हैं, और वो कॉन्टैक्ट्स आपको कहाँ से मिलते हैं? आज कोई प्लेटफॉर्म है क्या जहाँ से आप कॉन्टैक्ट्स ले सको, अपने लोगों तक पहुँच सको? बी टू बी बिजनेस ही हमारा ज़्यादा होता है. हम लोग यहाँ पे जितने भी लोग हैं ऑलमोस्ट बी टू बी वाले हैं. बी टू सी तो यहाँ बहुत कम होंगे. बी टू सी को तो राटा ने पहले ही निकाल के बाहर कर दिया था, बी टू बी बच गए थे. तो बी टू बी में आपको ये प्लेटफॉर्म जैसा प्लेटफॉर्म कोई भी दूसरा नहीं है अपनी कंट्री में। तो जो फील्ड में हैं आप, और कुछ नहीं, आप मेयर को ही पूछ लीजिए या जो भी कमिटी मेंबर पुराने हैं उनको पूछ लीजिए कि उनको आपस में कितना बिजनेस, कितना नो हाउ, कितना हेल्प मिलता है। चलो बिजनेस की बात भी छोड़ दो, बिजनेस के अलावा आपके पर्सनल जो प्रॉब्लम्स है उसके लिए जो राटा से हेल्प मिलती है ना, कोई भी जगह आपको नहीं मिलती। इवन आप कोर्ट में जाओगे ना तो भी आपको डिसीजन नहीं मिलेगा। जितना जल्दी डिसीजन आप राटा के प्लेटफॉर्म पे आके आप ले सकते हो, जितना आप डिस्प्यूट यहाँ क्लियर कर सकते हो। अरे देखो, किसी से डिस्प्यूट है अगर आपका क्लियर हो गया तो आपका बिजनेस बढ़ेगा, आपकी माउथ पब्लिसिटी बढ़ेगी कि देखो उसका डिस्प्यूट है वो खत्म हो गया। ऐसी बहुत सारी चीजें हैं। अगर मैं बोलने जाऊँ ना तो यहाँ पे एक घंटा आपको मैं ये बता सकता हूँ कि राटा से आपको क्या क्या फायदे कैसे कैसे हो सकते हैं। बट राटा डे का सेलिब्रेशन है, मैं इतना ही बता सकता हूँ, इतना ही बोल सकता हूँ कि आपको आपके बिजनेस में, आपके पर्सनल ग्रोथ में जो राटा आपको हेल्प कर सकती है कोई दूसरा ऑर्गेनाइजेशन नहीं कर सकता, फ्री में। पैसे देके भी उतनी हेल्प नहीं होती है जितनी राटा फ्री में कर रही है। ये बात है। यस मीर, हो आई एम ओके।
आपके आपके लिए हम स्पेशल प्रोग्राम करने वाले हैं
एक घंटे के लिए।
एक घंटे के लिए।
डन डन डन।
सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फॉर मीर सर।
मुझे मेरे सर के ऊपर करना है, मुझे पूछना है।
In your experience, how has Rata evolved over the period of time?
Wow. I think this has to be the shortest answer because I think aaj jis tarah se humne first generation ko suna, okay, current generation ka jis tarah se Paras bhai ne bola, but the biggest evolution what I am seeing is ke maine jo suna hai jis tarah se ke Rata ka basically formation hua tha because hume ek awaaz chahiye thi jo government mein hum reach out kar sake. ओके एंड वो टाइम पे आपका लाइसेंसिंग का जमाना था जहां पे वो स्पेसिफिक लाइसेंसेस दिए जाते थे ट्रेड को एंड इट वाज द वॉइस फॉर विच स्पेसिफिकली राटा वाज देयर। वी हैड आई थिंक फोर राटास, वन वाज इन साउथ, वन वाज इन ईस्ट, वन वाज इन नॉर्थ एंड वन वाज इन वेस्ट, और वो इकट्ठा होके ये चलते थे। एंड आज ये सर्कल ऑफ लाइफ देखिए कि आज वापस हम उन्हीं 13 अलग अलग कमिटी के द्वारा वापस वो सर्कल को पूरा फॉर्म कर रहे हैं। And it is absolutely, ये जर्नी जिस तरह से चली है, this is simply amazing. मैं personally 2010 से जुड़ा हुआ हूँ राटा के साथ में और मैंने जो ग्रोथ देखी है राटा की, and one person we all have to really thank, of course, yes, आज हमने गोसावी साहब को सुना। गोसावी साहब ने जिस तरह से इसके पूरे के पूरे अच्छी तरह से हमें कॉन्सेप्ट समझाए थे, हम कहाँ पे भी कोई भी कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल इश्यू में अटकते थे, गोसावी साहब वॉज ओनली वन फोन कॉल। All our former presidents, आज की तारीख में मुंबई जैसी जगह में आप अगर एक ऑफिस अपनी लेके रख रहे हो तो this entire credit goes to our past presidents and the kind of financial discipline. Financial discipline मैंने राटा में सीखी है। राटा की कोई भी मीटिंग सबसे पहले बैलेंस शीट डिस्कशन के साथ में होती है and this is the best possible thing what you can do. आप evolution देखो, उसके बाद में आप गुरनानी साहब देखो, उन्होंने पॉजिटिविटी लेके आई, बट आज की तारीख में राटा जो है that credit goes to I think one person and that is Mr. Paras Singh. I think each one of us we agree on that. उन्होंने जिस तरह से हम सबको जोड़ के लेके आए, एक strong platform create किया और उसके बाद में फिर जो हमारा नरेंद्र मोदी आया है, अजीत पनीकर, उसने जो rocket चलाया है, मतलब मैं तो I think समझ रहा हूँ कि I think अगले 3-4 साल के अंदर मेरे ख्याल से Rata will be present all around the world. Forget about India. In moon also, sorry, I think Akash is going one step further. So yes, evolving process was that we started as small somewhere where the concept was that it is a traders association. Today it has indeed become a trade association. Now we have gone and we have said that we are voice of MSMEs across India. And trust me, this association will be voice of refrigeration and air conditioning of entire India and perhaps down the line of the world.
मेर, तेरे साथ मैं एक चीज और ऐड करना चाहूंगा कि जो सपोर्ट मेरे को, जो सपोर्ट मेरे को पास, बोलू ना
आवाज आ रही है,
जो सपोर्ट मेरे को जो पास प्रेसिडेंट से मिला और उनसे जो गिफ्ट मिले ना, वो गिफ्ट मेरे सामने है सब। वो गिफ्ट का नाम लूं, अजीत, मिहिर, आकाश, प्रीतेश भाई, टिंकू जी, आई थिंक एवरी वन, इनके जो फादर थे उन्होंने जो काम किया और जाते जाते मतलब प्रेसिडेंटशिप से जाते जाते उन्होंने जो गिफ्ट दिए अपने बच्चों को, वो आज सामने आपके, आई थिंक और भी होंगे, मैं अगर कोई नाम भूल रहा हूँ तो, इवन हर्षल भी, हर्षल के फादर भी एक्टिव थे, देन और कौन है आकाश, याद कराओ,
पंकज और दीपक जी,
यस पंकज दीपक, उनके फादर्स भी काफी एक्टिव थे, पंकज के उलास जी, देन दीपक डालमिया है ना, उनके जो फादर थे आप लोगों को नहीं मालूम है, वो भी बहुत हेल्प किया करते थे। तो ईच एंड एवरी फादर ने अपने बच्चों को यहाँ पे भेजा ताकि ये एसोसिएशन आगे इतना ग्रो कर सके। सो नॉट माय एफर्ट, ऑल एफर्ट्स फ्रॉम माय पास्ट प्रेसिडेंट, थैंक यू। यस मीर,
परुष भाई आर यू देयर?
यस परुष भाई इज वेरी मच देयर।
Yes, I am there, Arshil bhai.
The next question is for you.
Arush bhai, pehle video on karo.
Photo bahut achhi hai lekin.
Sorry, I am here. Video thora low light hai yahan.
Okay. Please.
Yeah.
Chalo, I'll ask you the question. Where do you see Rata in future?
Okay. Where do I see Rata in future? Rata, aise toh bahut badhiya chalu hua hai. And we seeing the past president's video today gives me immense inspiration of how things could move on and how they visioned this long back. Like one of the past presidents said, we were sitting with in Volta's house and having meetings. So ye dekhke to lagta hai ki Rata ka agar message properly jaise Ajit ji abhi rocket kar rahe hai to bahut aage jayega. And trust me, air conditioning industry needs a very good mouthpiece. Jo abhi jo direction chal raha hai Rata ka, wo actual right bang on time direction ke saath chal raha hai. Jo COVID ke baad hum sabko jo ek mouthpiece chahiye government listening ke liye. Aur ye government bhi kafi reciprocative hai. So my saying this is Rata is going to have a very bright and a very good future. Yes, people have to understand and lot of participation, like Parasji also said, good participation needs to be there. Because participation ke saath strength hona chahiye, wo bhi bahut important hai, agar voice ko strong karna hai apne trade ka. Yes, sir.
Thank you, Paruji. Urvesh bhai.
हेलो
उर्वेश भाई, व्हाट द प्लान द नेशनल कमिटी हैज द ग्रोथ फॉर राटा पैन इंडिया? What is the plan of the National Committee to grow Rata Pan India?
To grow Rata Pan India. I would like to answer this question in Hindi. Hamara 2 saal baad mein jo achieve karne ka plan tha, that all thanks to pandemic, we have achieved that today. इससे अच्छा कुछ जवाब हो सकता है?
दोबारा पेंडेमिक लाना पड़ेगा क्या? और
उर्विश भाई है ना, हमेशा किफायती बात करते हैं, शॉर्ट एंड स्वीट,
बट राम वैसा ही करते हैं, शॉर्ट एंड स्वीट।
बट उर्विश भाई, माय सब्सिक्वेंट क्वेश्चन टू यू इज कि आप यहां से राटा को पैन इंडिया में और फर्दर हम लोग किस तरह से ग्रो करके लेके जा सकते? That is what something we want.
Rather, what I'm seeing in West, yes, we are growing fantastic. South may be movement अच्छा आ गया है. Now we need to focus more little bit on the North and majority in East also. East we have Kolkata is shaping up, but there are other bigger cities also there that we need to focus on. Or North may be इसको ज़्यादा spread करना पड़ेगा. Activities yes, in West we are seeing activities, in South also we are seeing activities. But there are still major centers are left out. जहां तक मेंबरशिप हम बात करें तो अगर मैं अहमदाबाद में बैठा हूँ, इफ आई थिंक ऑफ ओनली अहमदाबाद, तो मेरा स्कोप लिमिटेड है. अहमदाबाद में सभी लोग जुड़ेंगे, इट विल टेक टाइम, बट इफ आई टॉक अबाउट अहमदाबाद, आई कैन टेक केयर ऑफ द सराउंडिंग ऑफ द अहमदाबाद. Like that, each and every city, those presidents are active, those membership committees are active. They need to focus out on the surrounding areas. आपके आजू-बाजू में जो twin cities हैं, छोटे-छोटे cities हैं या छोटे-छोटे towns भी हैं, वहाँ से भी HVAC and R trade वाले को जहाँ आप connected हो, may they be your corporate customer, may they be your vendor, supplier, contractor, whomsoever, just reach out to them and connect them with the RATA. ऐसे ही राटा का स्प्रेड पैन इंडिया फास्टर ग्रोथ होगा.
जस्ट अ क्विक ऐड ऑन टू व्हाट उर्वेश भाई सर. सी उर्वेश भाई, वन थिंग दैट यू नीड टू, वन एवरीथिंग एवरीवन नीड्स टू अंडरस्टैंड इज गुजरात इज द ओनली स्टेट दैट वी हैव थ्री कमिटीज, राइट? एंड द क्रेडिट गोज टू द मेंबर्स ऑफ गुजरात हु आर वेरी फोर्थकमिंग इन डूइंग दिस. सो ओवर द नेक्स्ट 2 years गुजरात विल बिकम अ मॉडल फॉर ऑल द अदर स्टेट्स. And which is what is the biggest achievement that Gujarat can actually give us. So over the next 2 years, these three committees, how they turn around the entire state will become the model for even for the north, even for the east, even for the south. And that will be a big takeaway for us. So that is the clear expectation which we have from Gujarat. And I am quite optimistic that that's what's going to happen.
So what I shared, now I started reaching out to the Rajkot and Bhavnagar and Mehsana also.
That's right, sir.
और हमारे पास ये जब भी कुछ एग्जांपल आते हैं ना कुछ नया करने के लिए, वो उर्वेश भाई से आते हैं, अहमदाबाद कमेटी से आते हैं, या फिर कभी वडोदरा से भी आया. तो ये लोग जो गुजरात वाले हैं ना कुछ इनोवेशन करते रहते हैं और हमको आगे बढ़ने के लिए मोटिवेशन मिलती रहती है, नई नई आइडियाज भी मिलते रहते हैं.
सर, इट्स माय फेस, बट मेरे साथ में जो टीम बैठी है ना वो मुझे आइडिया देते रहते हैं, उसको मैं कुछ या थोड़ा मोड़ी भी आइडिया देते हैं.
इसके लिए रियली थैंक्स. यस,
दैट्स माय टीम्स आइडियाज.
और मैं चाहता हूं कि हमारी सभी नेशनल कमेटियां ना ऐसी ही बने जैसी आपकी कमेटी है. ये मेरी दिल से इच्छा है और आई थिंक नेशनल कमेटी के जो भी लोग हैं वो सब कमेटियों को ऐसा ही बनाएंगे जैसी कि आज अहमदाबाद कमेटी है.
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर योर काइंड वर्ड्स.
सुबु सर, आर यू देयर?
यस सुबु इज
देयर. यस कैन हियर मी?
यस.
सुबु सर, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज
फॉर यू. या शूट आउट, लेट्स सी.
How is RATA different from other trade associations?
Perfect question for
good
you.
Question.
How is RATA different from other trade associations?
You have been a national president of ISHRAE. You have been there. You have seen that. How do you see a difference?
See, number one, RATA is a very vibrant association. And before that, it was formed in 1949. I think as soon as independence, I think it looks like, you know, we are waiting for independence to be declared. And then you form the association immediately, right? And that is one of the oldest association. That is the strength of RATA. And I see really vibrant association. The power of teamwork, the power of, you know, the synergy, what I find across the RRCs, across India, all the business owners, all the members is very powerful. And we use, you know, what is the strength of Gujarat. Now, definitely, as Ajit said, Gujarat is, they play a major role. Now, Mumbai was playing a major role and will continue to play a major role. And with that, you know, with that strong pad, launch pad, now South was launched. Now, Gujarat, Ahmedabad was launched and other cities. And Delhi, again, is going to be a major one, major power center. We are definitely, you know, it's not like one region. It's like a national kind of a framework. And compared to other associations, I find that there is a lot of commitment from every member of RATA, every business owner and member. They want to contribute to RATA's growth. And I think, as Paras Bhai rightly said, I don't think anyone has reached to Nitin Gadkari, Honorable Minister, or Honorable Minister Piyush Goyal. I think now our next destination is Prime Minister.
And I don't think any association has reached to that level. And this is the power of RATA. It's much, much, much more powerful than any other society.
Subhu ji, aapke committee ke liye kuch bolna chahta
hai. Bharat bhai, ek second.
Yeah.
Subhu ji, yes. What is the vision of RATA?
Vision of RATA is, before government takes any decision on any matters regarding refrigeration, air conditioning, trade, RATA has to be consulted and then a decision has to be made. And that will come sooner than later. In every decision, RATA will be involved.
Next question.
Thank you.
Akash, this is for you. Yeah. How RATA helps to do business internationally?
Yeah, thanks, Harshal. So just as, we've been trying to reach our Prime Minister in India, we also find that our Prime Minister loves to travel all around the world. And that is what RATA has been doing for years. It has ensured that all the exhibitions that are pertaining to refrigeration, air conditioning or ventilation, whether it is Europe, Chilventa, whether it is China Refrigeration Show, whether it is Dubai, the Big Five, or whether it is the US AHR. We have ensured that we take our members who are interested to go and understand what is the experience and how is business carried on in those countries. It is such an overwhelming experience that after we go over there, the first day or so, when a member from India goes into that country, it's a completely new place for him. He only looks up at RATA, how are they hosting them over there. And that first day of comfort that they get from the RATA committee, who ensures that everybody is ready to take advantage of the next 3 days of the exhibition. And thereafter, the evenings to unwind, to get to know each other, and to actually bond. When you come back on the fifth day back to India, you completely have a different relationship with each other. So aapne jaake wahan pe dhanda bhi kar diya, aapne wahan se seekh bhi li ki wahan ke kya naye technologies hain ya naye products hain jo hum leke aa sakte hain. Aur एक इतने बड़े पैमाने पे आपने एक दूसरे के साथ एक ऐसा रिलेशनशिप और बॉन्ड बना दिया है कि वो चीज इट इज जस्ट देयर टू ग्रो एंड रियली दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट आई फील व्हाइल RATA इज ग्रोइंग. वी मे हैव बीन 100 मेंबर्स एंड टुडे वी आर 100 कमिटी मेंबर्स एंड व्हाटएवर द विजन इज, इफ इट इज टू मेक 6,000 मेंबर्स, इफ इट इज टू इन्फ्लुएंस सो मेनी पीपल इन आवर ट्रेड, the most important thing that we have to go ahead with is trusting each other. Agar hum hamara ghar mein ek dusre ke sath united rahenge to bahar wala kuch nahi kar payega, and we will ensure that we reach whatever vision we have in terms of coming together with other trade or other government bodies. But we need to be one, we need to trust each other, we need to ensure that if today I want to share some of my problems with somebody who is with me in the room, I'm open to do that. Because remember, when you give one, you will get 10 back from the person who you trust. So this is the thing that I feel all of us should take forward and take advantage of these trade exhibitions that we have had in the past. Pankaji has led them very, very well because of his experience that he has. I think the only thing he must not be knowing is the foreign language. Baki wo sab sign language mein karwa dete hain hamare members ke liye once we go to these various countries. And now, even more important, when the government is saying Atmanirbhar and you want to bring those things to India, go there, learn, come back, adopt it, and grow it multifold. That is the only way all of us will remain profitable and very, very relevant for our trade. Thank you.
Very, very well answered. And I think one rider to you, which I would like to ask you concern this thing. The biggest highlight what we see when we go abroad, it is not about whether it is your RATA delegation or something. We are seen as an
Indian delegation. And doesn't it give you those goosebumps, or it gives you that pride that you are representing your country?
Neil, I would say that the goosebumps, even if I see a photograph with 80 or 100 delegates from India who go in front of the exhibition hall and they stand with the Indian national flag, that is the biggest thing that gives me goosebumps, makes me proud of being an Indian, and makes me proud of being a Rataian. So we must continue this thing.
Thank you, Akash. Neil bhai, the next question is for you. What impact will Gen X have on Rata?
So I think I'll turn it around. Let me ask you this question. What do you think is the impact of Gen X going to be on Rata? So why don't you come and sit? And I want all the Gen X guys to come here. Come. I think we have Pallav in Ahmedabad. We have Pranav in Chennai. If he's around. Yeah, I Pratik in Bangalore. May I please request, and I mean, I want to ask you, what do you think you guys can do? I mean, if you want to ask me my answer, Paras bhai had me, Ajit, Tinku ji, Akash as a Gen X. I think now we guys have you as Gen X. So you give us the answer that what do you think is going to be your contribution? They were not at all prepared for this question.
No, it was not something.
Answer. Come on.
Here, they will rock as usual.
Yeah, come on.
What Gen X can do, Gen X can actually, first thing I would say, we have across India, we have committees in big cities. So I would say all the committee members to give some, throw up and ask Gen X to get involved in government. So Gen X can go to government and tell them ke 18% ka jo 28 se 18 ka jo issue hai, that we can do. 18 se jo 12 karna hai, that we can do. And other MSME problems which is being faced by other manufacturers, traders, and n number of people, that can be solved by Gen X. Because future mein Gen X is going to work. These people have already done their work. So they have already done their work. Now it is our time to give our time to Rata and to trade and do something for trade.
Super. What about you, Dhrumil? I want to hear from you.
So come, Dhrumil. I have an interesting story to share. First of all, I'll talk about the present for Rata. What happened was, I had gone to one of the networking meets. It was in town. And I had met Mr. Ajoy Kant Dhruya there. So his dad was one of the founders of Rata during that time, during 1949. So I just asked him to join. So he told me that no, my dad was only one of the founders there. He said one of the coolest organization during that time. They used to take that time of Gen X for beer party and everything. So he had that perception of...
So you come here for beer party?
No. I don't mind. But so that's the perception of what Rata is. So it is how it is different from other trade organizations. So that is how. And for future, so we can take the whole industry to the next level. And the vision of our PM, which is the Atmanirbhar Bharat, I think we can take it forward practically and up there to the next level.
So. Very, very well said. I always say we are hot guys in cool trade, and that's what we are all about. So, Hardik bhai, question to you. What do you think that Gen X is going to do? I'm going to ask each and every Gen X guys who are here.
So, we would like to take it to the next level. We will sort out, we will ask all the young people what their problems are. I'm sure we all have different problems. We all have gone through certain problems, but now we also have a different vision to it, a different version to it. So, we try and ask everybody, get solutions to those problems. Try and involve a lot of young people in the committee, make them more active. There are a lot of programs which we'll be doing, and we'll help Rata as much as we can. Just more of us, hopefully by this year end or something, we can have 5-10 people more, how many ever more, will be helpful for us.
Super, Hardik bhai. Amitesh, over to you. This is amazing. So on my left side is Amitesh, and on my right side is Shubha ma'am. Mother and son, both of them on the, I think I'll try and get them on the same screen. If I can, one second. Yeah.
Okay, I think I'll move back. Why don't you sit back?
Brother, sister,
yeah. Brother, sister. Sorry.
What I feel is Rata as a Gen Next, we can actually get many more Melas, like VRF Melas, and you know, we can do many more things. The first thing I would like to go with is that many generations, like the next generation is coming up. I've seen many people, you know, the parents are behind the children that you need to come back, and you know, when they go abroad for studies, they need to come back and take over the business. But some children, they are not very much keen in taking this HVAC, coming into the HVAC industry and moving with their father's business. So first, I would like to understand that, and I would like to show them the advantages of this HVAC industry and take Gen Next to another level.
So one more thing to add. He was the one of the person who was thinking whether to come into this business or not. Am I right or am I wrong?
Am I right or am I right? And today, if you go to see, in most of the, we find that more girls are there who are taking, majoring in HVAC as the master, subject. So I find a lot of women are also entering into this industry, and that itself is a good sign. So I'm sure, like, you know, the next generation will really look forward, and they will always be a active role in this industry for all of us.
Thank you. So I think moving over from one set of parents and child to another set of parents, we have Pratik and Mulinder ji who are there in Bangalore. So Pratik, over to you, buddy. What do you think is going to be your contribution?
Good evening. Moving forward from what Amitesh has just said, right? So, I mean, we are this unique position where we can actually connect with people who want to join the business, right? So we've just joined the business. So we are in the position to tell them that, there is a future for this industry, as Amitesh had rightly said. But I think the bigger problem is that my generation doesn't feel this industry is very glamorous. So with that, we have to show them that, it is glamorous and you can make a career out of this entire thing for yourselves. It doesn't have to be a cushy 9-to-5 office job or a corporate setup where you have your Nescafe is brought to your table every 5 minutes, right? It doesn't have to be that. But I mean, at the end of the day, when you talk about what you can possibly take home, sky's the limit when it comes to the HVAC industry. So, I've had an experience in corporate. I worked there for 3 years at a big MNC, and now I'm working here. So I see the difference. There's a lot of difference.
What is the difference that what you see when you are talking about a corporate? Because, this is what I think majority of the Generation Next guys would be having in their mind. You know, so, one is that totally glossy corporate life.
Yeah, yeah.
And one is actually dirtying your hand on the field. And that is Absolutely. What is the biggest strength of HVAC in our industry.
So I'll tell you, I mean, the fundamental difference between these two is what you've learned in corporate, right? Big corporates are process-driven organizations. Once you reach that level, over here, you get to set the process. Most of the businesses in our industry today, right? If there's a Gen Next who can come in and set processes, he can grow his business multifold. There's nothing stopping him from doing that. The issue is nobody wants to set those processes. Once you're able to set those processes, you don't have to do anything. The work will be done. You will be able to do the work.
Superb. Thank you. Lovely answer. Do we have Pranav from Chennai? Pranav, are you there? Sridhar sir, is Pranav around? Okay, till I think Pranav joins in. Can we have Rishabh? Rishabh, are you around?
Yes, I'm there. Yeah.
Yes, Rishabh. I think we have had a lot of international trips together.
Yes.
Right. And I think we have had a lot of these conversations in a different style altogether. Right. Yeah. But today, on a serious note, I want to ask you that, I mean, you, now you are part of this young and vibrant Rata.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, there is a clear cut, you know, zeal, or I mean, you can see fire in the belly of all the members or all the committee members. Where do you think is Rata heading towards?
See, I think the foundation has been laid pretty well. Now we just have to dwell on it. It is very much clear. Like, we just have to follow the process. Like me, when I joined Rata, it was long time back, I think 2015. Around that time, along with you guys, I went to China trip. That's when I understood the power of Rata, when they first did the MOU with the China refrigeration team. And that's when I understood like how important it is to get connected with an association. And it's not just one voice you take up to the China refrigeration. As a whole, you gain strength. Let's suppose somebody, some trader, have a problem someday. If he himself is going to the China refrigeration, probably they might not listen to him. But if you're going through the association, I think definitely because of the MOU, because of the long-term relationship which we have built with the international committee, I think definitely, though, and for the generation next, this is what I foresee. I especially believe in all these international connects. They have to be very strong. What I see over the period of time is our Rata stalls to be there in all the big exhibitions all over the world. And that's when the connect will happen. That's when the MOUs will happen. And that's when our strength as a whole association will be manifested.
Very, very, very well said, Rishabh. And I think you have summed it up very well. Is Pranav come back? Pranav, you are there from Chennai? Okay, so thank you. I think this question was for me, but I just flipped it over to the Generation Next guys. And I think we got a lot of insights from you people. As I said, I think you guys are the next four, which we are expecting you guys to take it forward and really looking for a great fireworks from each one of you. Harshal, you can take it over from here, the next question. Thank you very much, Generation Next, for this lovely program, what you guys have done. Simply outstanding.
Pratik, last two questions for you.
Yeah, hi, Ajit. I have a couple of questions for you. Ajit?
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah. Hi, good evening. So, couple of quick questions, right? Now, as you take baby steps back into normalcy post-COVID, right? How do you see Rata operating? One, right? And the second question is, how will Rata adopt more technology than it currently is to enable better functioning, better streamlined processes for Rata as a whole?
So I'm glad that you're asking that question. In fact, I was pretty impressed with the way you guys spoke and shared that thoughts of yours. So first of all, coming out of COVID, you know, the biggest mistake that most of us are facing is, you know, or are going to do is, we only have one agenda. And the agenda that we are all looking at is, how do I get back to my business, right? Because you have all not made money, you've lost money, you've gone through a pain. So only top thing on your mind is, how do I start making money? And I think this is where you got to make a difference. What you need to do is, before you step out tomorrow post-COVID, which most of us have already done, take a pause and see what happened, right? How many of you all believed that nothing will go wrong with my business? What actually happened during the COVID? What part of your business got affected? Why did it get affected? How do you have to, you have to learn from that. See, history has always a lesson for all of us. And I guess each of us need to pause and look back from our own businesses, and the impact is different. How many people have I been able to retain? How many people have I replaced? Why did I lose people? Why was I not able to start my office within the first 2 months, 3 months, while somebody else started within 1 month, somebody else started for 3 months? These are the questions that you need to ask yourself. That itself is your strategy post-COVID. And the other important thing, when you asked about technology, see, technology is an enabler. It is like a tool. You know, most of us understand the importance of using good tools for operational purposes. You know, I've always seen that I've always gone to a lot of places where people invest in expensive tools and they keep it and then they actually ration out these tools. अच्छा ये technician use करना चाहिए, ये नहीं use करना चाहिए, ये tool खराब हो जाएगा. And some people even think, you know, why is the reason to buy a tool? And I am saying this confidently because I have seen a time when vacuum pumps were never being purchased. People were very happy to do it with the old compressors and everything. You have to invest. These are all enablers. So you need a good tool to run a good business, a good efficient business. So is the case with technology. If anybody believes that your business will survive without technology, you're living in a fool's paradise. It cannot happen. You cannot say that my age is, I have already crossed that age, so I cannot use it, or I'm not good. You don't have a choice. If you want your business to survive, you will have to learn it. You have to, like how you have dirty your hands in the business, you have to take time out and you have to learn how to, what technology is all about, how is it going to impact your business. This is extremely important because in today's world, the process, what you were talking about, Prateek, is actually controlled not through a written SOP. That time has changed. The written SOP age is gone. It is technology that controls the SOP. So what it literally is happening is you are breaking the pyramid which was required to build it. It is becoming more leaner and meaner organizations. You don't have multiple levels like owners and managers and supervisors and then, you know, team leaders, and that is going. Now it is becoming simpler and it is good for small businesses because the moment the layers of control break, your cost starts coming down dramatically. And the only way to control that is through technology. So this is most important thing. So to your answers, two things: stop, pause, see what went wrong, prepare. Second, believe that without technology, you can't survive. Go out and learn it yourself. That's the only way to go ahead.
Fair enough.
Thanks, Prateek, for that super question that you asked, Ajit, because no meeting could have been complete without all the way Ajit has taken Rata and used the COVID situation to ensure all of us are together more than we have been pre-COVID. Thanks, Ajit, for that answer. Before the vote of thanks, I will like to invite our backbones and our back-end team from the office, Savita and Vishaka, to come over here and tell all of us, along with Manohar, that what is their experience at Rata during these COVID times.
Come.
Good evening, everyone. Happy Rata Day. Experience actually, very nice experience. I was nothing. Actually, Rata has built me up. So frankly speaking, आज मैं जो भी हूँ ना, मैं नाम अपना मिस राटा को देती हूँ. उसके वजह से मैं आज बहुत अच्छे प्लेटफॉर्म पे हूँ, actually. And we have worked very hard to do this with all the committee members' help. Everybody has helped me very nice and understood me very nicely. And all that I can say. That's it. Thank you so much.
Yes, hello everyone. Thank you. Rata जब से join किया बहुत मतलब बहुत कुछ सीखने मिला actually और अच्छा भी लगा क्योंकि मैं नहीं होती Rata ने join की सब अजय सर ने online ही मिले सब online सब मुझे help किया कि Rata में क्या work है क्या नहीं. तो सविता मैम और नी सर आकाश सर committee member ने सब मुझे support किया. शुभा मैम, जसप्रीत सर, हर्षल सर और नी सर. Thank you, sir. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, sir.
And this relay that we have, you know, which was done, making Rata successful, ensuring that, you know, every day and night in this whole movement of growing, if there were people to fall back on, it was this team over here. And
that's because Akash sir, Ajit sir, Mihir sir, everybody supported us, sir, because they are always there for help with that.
And I cannot complete the celebration if I don't call the person who handed over the baton to Vishaka and Savita, that is Veenal, who has come as a surprise element and a guest of honor back to the Rata office, because I think it is because she left her phone charger over here and then she has come to pick it up. I'm not sure, but I will let Veenal take it from there.
I'm so glad to see everybody. Hi, Ajit sir. Hi, Arvind sir. Paras sir. Poru sir. Subbu sir. How are you all?
Hi, Veenal.
So you can mute
Akash, you can mute that Zoom. There is no problem, we can hear Veenal even otherwise.
Veenal, you have to come to Rata to get recharged.
So this is what Rata is made of. The ones who have been there.
Sorry to interrupt. I actually want to thank everybody and this platform that Ajit sir, you gave me. We had a vision when we started. When I started, we were at like 120 odd companies as members of Rata in 2013. And today we are like more than 6,000, 7,000 odd companies coming together. The vision was to bring Rata pan-India. I remember that three people sitting on the table, Deepak sir, you and Paras sir, and asking me, "Aap kaise aage leke jaoge? We have to do so many activities." Sir, today privately I can say that we have already taken a lot of activities, we have taken a lot of changes, bringing in the next, Gen Next, Amitesh, Harshal sir, how we have handpicked everybody. You have to come. Akash sir, who is to run away? Harris, sir, aana this meeting. So I can just memorize all those old days. We created a lot of memories and still many more memories in Rata Kitty to come.
Very well, sir.
Fantastic.
I would ask Subbu sir to do vote of thanks.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much.
One second.
Yeah, yes, Mihir.
Before Subbu sir, you do the vote of thanks, there was a question in the chat which says, what are we going to do on the 75th year of celebration? And what we heard today from our one of our past presidents that for the 50th year, they took 2 years of preparation. So I think it is a cue for all of us. We have to do 3 years of preparation for the 75th year of celebration. And that's what we will sure do it on a grand manner. Subbu sir, over to you for the vote of thanks.
Great. Dear friends, it's an extremely great honor for me to do the vote of thanks on behalf of every Rata member sitting here across India. This kind of occasion, I think it's very rare in the history of association and societies to come, where across India it is like a chain reaction, like one RRC cuts the cake, the other RRC is cutting the cake. And we are beating all the online COVID story and all that. It's a great event. Next Gen is some group who are just energizing the whole Rata. We are so happy, so proud. They are there to take the flag to the next level, to put it across at Mount Everest top. I think there's nothing short of that. And they will play a great role, I'm sure. And hearing from all our past presidents and very senior members on the history of Rata, how they sat together, they have remembered even situations where they sat in some office, discussed something. It's so exciting, so nice to, hear all those old stories and remembrances of them. It's a great thing. And Ajit, you're doing a fantastic job. We have a president in Rata who is, who is a film director, who is doing a lot of things. And the next gen can learn a lot of things from him. He is very young, even though I don't think he is still part of the next gen team. And Mihir and Parasbhai and our James Bond, Akash, and everyone across India, great team. And we profusely thank every Rata member who is there. And one request to all the Rata members, please let us know what Rata needs to do for you and what Rata needs to do to take your voice to the government to the perfect place where you want to take and what you want to take, and it will be done. So be take an active role and be part of RATA, and you know, tell us what we need to do, and we will all be there, pull the strength across India, be it north, east, south or west, and then we will turn the corners. Thank you so much for joining on this wonderful day, and we look forward to meeting every one of you. And as Mehir Bhai rightly said, let's start preparations for 75th year. Thank you so much. Thank you. And thanks, Rinal. Thanks, the office team, Savita and Visakha.
So thank you, guys. I think.
Thank you, sir.
So guys, thank you very much for joining in from all parts of India. Thank you very much. Bye. Bye-bye. Take care. Stay safe.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Mr. James Bond. Mm-hmm.